Good morning, dear students. In this video lecture, we will be studying quadratic equation. I hope all of you are familiar with quadratic equation, but let me start with a basic few explanations. Now, all of you know what is polynomial. Polynomial, right? It is a combination of constant and variables separated by plus minus and have the operations multiplication and division. Like I say x square, x cube, let's start with cube, x cube, x is 2a, 2x square plus x plus 5. This is what? This is a polynomial. If I write x plus 1, this is again a polynomial. Y plus 2xy plus 5 plus 7z. This all are polynomials. Having so how many terms here in this we are having? Total 4 terms. Here we are having 2 terms. Here we are having again 4 terms. Now if you see how many variables are here, there are 1 variable. Here again 1 variable. Here you see in this polynomial how many variables are there? 1, x, y and z. That means 3 variables. 3 variables. Now, x, y, z and this constant is 5, here 1 is constant, here 5 is again constant. So, all these are called polynomials and have how many variables? 1 variable, 3 variables. Now, what is the degree of this polynomial? This one, degree will be the highest exponent of the variable. Highest exponent here, if you see, it is given 3. So, degree is equal to 3. Here, highest exponent or power of the variable is 1. So in this case, degree is equal to 1. Now in this case, let me write here like 4, here 3 and 2. Now what is the degree here? Here having power 1, here having power 4, here I am having x to s power 3, y to s power 2. So their sum will be equal to 5. So here we are having degree is equal to 5. Now I hope all of you could understand, all of you had understand that these are all are called as polynomials. They are represented with variables, so they may be called as 1 variable, 2 variable polynomial, 3 variable polynomial, n number of variables can be there. Similarly, degrees is the highest exponent of the variable. Here 3, here 1, here this. Now, when we have power is equal to 1 to of any polynomial, this is polynomial, x plus 1. So, this will be called as linear. This will be called as linear polynomial. Polynomial in one variable. Right? Why it is called one variable? Because of x. Why it is called linear? Because it is having power 1. If I have x plus y plus 1, then this will be called as linear polynomial in two variables. Okay, why? Because x and y, two variables are there, power is 1 1. Now we are coming on to the quadratic equation. When we have x square plus 1, right? So here we are having, what is the power here? So this is called as quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial in one variable. Now in this case, here I will be getting value of x is equal to only one value, strict value, that will also be equal to 1. If I compare it with equal to, x plus 1 is equal to 0 if I write. So I will be getting one value, right? If I will be writing x plus 1 less than, greater than or any other symbol, then I will get more number of solutions, more than one solution. I have discussed this thing in linear inequation chapter linear equation in equation in one variable. I hope all of you remember this. So when something is compared with equal to, that becomes an equation. Right now all these are polynomials. I hope all of you are aware of all these things, but still, to clean up your memory, to clean up, to brush up the dust that is given or that is present, or due to time we don't remember all these things, small things. So just to make you aware once again, I just reminded you, recalled it. Now x plus 1 linear polynomial, x plus y again in two variable, here one variable, here one quadratic equation. Now if I have like x square plus 2x plus 1, so this will be called as quadratic polynomial. This is called as quadratic polynomial. This much is clear. Now when we compare this with any value, x plus 2x plus 1 is equal to either say 7, 4, 3, 2, whatever, or 0, then this becomes quadratic equation. This becomes quadratic equation. I hope all of you are clear, my dear students. So this is what x square plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. Because of this equal to, we say it as equation. So what type of equation it is? Quadratic equation. What type of polynomial it is? Quadratic polynomial. If I have x plus 1, so it will be called as polynomial. And if I write x plus 1 is equal to 0, then it will be called as polynomial equation. Understood? Though it is linear, so I can write linear equation. When I have x plus 1 less than 0 or greater than 0, greater than equal to, less than equal to, then it is called linear inequation. Now, in this chapter, we have to study this thing. X square plus 2x plus 1 equal to 0. That means quadratic equation we are supposed to study here. So I hope you all will be clear about this. You all will be knowing all these things from beforehand. But still, I just made it clear once again so that it will be very easy for you to understand this chapter. Now, in this case, what you will see, there is one condition, that is coefficient of x square should not be equal to 0. So here, what is the expression? X square plus of 2x plus of 1 is equal to 0, right? What is the coefficient of x square here? 1. It is not equal to 0. It should not be equal to 0. Not be. Pay attention. X square, coefficient of x square should not be equal to 0. So here we are having 1. Now, in general form, standard quadratic equation is written as ax square plus of bx plus of c is equal to 0, where a is not equal to 0. This is the meaning, what I wrote in sentence, here it is represented, a not equal to 0 with symbol. Now, this is called the coefficient of x square is called as a. Generally, coefficient of x square is called as a. Coefficient of x is called as b, and one term that is constant is called as c. This is the standard form. In standard form, when we write an equation, quadratic equation, we always write in the form of first ax square, bx plus c. Here may be plus minus, no problem. But here generally we follow plus and plus only. So x square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is my standard quadratic equation. Standard quadratic equation. This is standard quadratic equation in which coefficient of x square is called as a, coefficient of x is called as b, coefficient constant is called as c. The constant, not the coefficient. Here I have not written up to here only coefficient. Here I have not written anything. Okay. So constant is called as c. Now we have to see what are the values means how do we calculate the nature of roots, how do we calculate, find out the solution. Now when we have this ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0, then this is our problem. Actually this is the problem that we are going to solve this. So what will be the solution of this problem? So we have to find the solution of the problem. So before that we have to understand two terms, that is roots and solution. Roots, if I have this equation, if ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and instead of x if I write some other value, some other constant value, say for 4, 2, 1, 0, decimal value, any number, so I can write a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. For this quadratic equation, if I am able to replace this x with another constant value, another numerical value, here x is what? Variable. Here x is variable, here alpha is constant. When I am able to represent this x with another constant value, and if my left hand side is equal to right hand side, if by putting the value of x of some values, whatever may be, if I put here, and if left hand side becomes equal to right hand side, that means left hand side becomes 0, then we say alpha is the root of the quadratic equation. We will substitute certain values of x which will make my this quadratic equation equal to 0, then that root, that alpha, the new value that I have assumed and kept, the value that I found and kept, which made this equation equal to 0, that alpha, that value is called as the root of the equation. Now, when we have got the root of the equation, then I can say x is equal to alpha is the solution to the given problem, ax square plus bx plus c. If I am getting the root, if I put in place of x that alpha, then we can say that alpha is the root, alpha is the solution of the given problem. So x equal to alpha is the solution. Now there is another word called satisfies. Satisfies means just we have to put the value, whatever number you get, you put it in place of x, and then you see if left hand side is again equal to right hand side equal to 0, that means that particular value satisfies the equation. So here, my dear students, you have to keep two things in mind. One is, what is root? Root is the numerical value which we keep on the quadratic equation such that left hand side is equal to right hand side, so that will be called as root. And when x is equal to alpha, we write that alpha is also called as the solution of the roots. So solution is the root of the equation. Every solution has its root. Every solution has its own root. Okay. Now, in case of linear equation, I was having how many answers? X was equal to 1, right? But in case of quadratic equation, always we will get two roots. That is two numerical values, that is also called as two solutions. Understood? In case of quadratic, we will always get two answers, that is two solutions, that is two roots. And in case of linear equation, we will always get one root, one solution, that is one. Means in case here, I will be getting other value also. In quadratic, do remember, we will get two values always. It will never be the situation, we will never see a situation when we will get only one root. The situation may come like we will be getting two same values, like plus 2 and plus 2, two solutions, but they are same. So always you remember, my dear student, please, I am repeating again and again. Why? Because I have seen my students last year and a year before that also, that students were always giving one answers. They were forgetting the next answers. Because of that, they were losing marks here as well as in board. That is why some of the good students whom I expected that they will get good marks, but they were making some silly mistakes. Among those silly mistakes, one mistake is of writing only one root of the quadratic equations. Now, here I will be discussing about nature of the roots, which is very important from exam point of view, because in this case, almost every year I can say, I have seen that question paper in which they generally ask the nature of the roots. What is the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation? They will not ask you to solve in some questions. In some questions, they will ask you to solve and give the solution up to one decimal place, up to two decimal place, or up to two significant figures, up to one significant figures, or 1/10 of the decimal, 1/100 of the decimal. So these are the possible questions that they ask generally. First, nature of roots. Second, they will ask you to find the solution up to 2 decimal place, 3 decimal place, or 1/10, 1/100 position, and so on. And there are many more I will be discussing when I will go through these questions. I hope it is clear. Now I will discuss nature of roots. Now, how to find nature of roots? I've told you standard equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. This is my quadratic equation. Now, to find the nature of roots, what we have to find? We have to find with the help of discrete. Now, in this, a is called the coefficient of x is called as a. So, we will write a coefficient of x square. First, we will find out coefficient of x square is equal to a. Coefficient of x is equal to b plus b here. You see, plus symbol is there. Constant is equal to plus of c. I am writing plus just to make you understand, because I have seen some of our students who do not pay attention, who don't study, or I would say they study but very less. They think that they will study a night before exam and then they will get good marks in mathematics. So I think it is not possible. I am not that much intelligent, so I am assuming that my students are also like me only. At least they may be better, they may be best, but I don't think so. I have gone through the papers, I have gone through their way of studying. So, okay, that part should not be dealt here. So, here x square, constant is equal to c. Now, when we have to calculate b square minus 4ac. Now, this is called discriminant. Discriminant, okay, this is called discriminant. Discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac. So this is your first formula of this chapter. So discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac, which is in short represented as d is equal to b square minus 4ac. Now, to find the nature of roots, when discriminant is greater than 0, when discriminant is greater than 0, then the roots are real and unequal. Then the roots are real and unequal. So what is discriminant here? So we will calculate as b square minus 4ac. When it is greater than 0, then we will be having two roots, real and unequal. Always you remember, we will always get two roots. Okay, but here we are finding nature of roots. So here, if this is greater than 0, b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, that means if this value is positive, then we will have real and unequal roots. Second case, when discriminant is equal to 0, then the roots are real and equal. My dear student, pay attention, I'm writing equal here, unequal. So how you have to write? B square minus 4ac is equal to 0. So you will be getting real and equal roots. Third point is, when discriminant is less than 0, then the roots are not real and unequal. Not real and unequal. That means b square minus 4ac is less than 0. Not real means what? Something that is not real is also called as imaginary. Something that is not real is also called as imaginary. So roots will be imaginary and unequal. Now, to understand all these, let us take one problem from our book. Suppose I am taking, now nature, based on nature of roots, in our textbook we have questions from 11 to 16. So I will tell you all, I would request you all, once you watch this video, you please solve the question from 11 to 16. Do not touch any other questions unnecessarily if you don't have any command on this chapter. First you go through this, then you solve from 11 to 16. Question number 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 and 16. Then we will discuss in the next lecture how to solve the quadratic equation. Now, first, question number 11 says that, question number 11, subpart A if I am taking, it is given x into x minus 1, sorry, x minus 2 plus 1 is equal to 0. Plus 1 is equal to 0. Find the discriminant of the following equations. Here, we have to find the discriminant only. So, we have to write discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac, correct? Now, as you know, how we have to find, first we have to convert this into standard equation, x square minus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0, correct? Now, a here is equal to plus 1, b is equal to minus 2 and c is equal to plus 1. Now, b is minus 2. So, minus 2 whole square minus 4 into a into c. So, it will be 2 2s are 4 minus 4. That means discriminant is equal to 0. Now, when we see another number, let's take question number 12. Now, from there also, I will find first discriminant only. Then I will discuss about this nature. So, question number 12. Just I am taking an example, okay, I am not solving question number 12 right now, my dear student. X square plus x plus 1 is equal to 0. So, discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac, as you all know. Here a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1, c is also equal to 1. So, 1 square minus 4 into 1 into 1. So, 1 minus 4, that is minus 3. So, what is my discriminant here? Minus 3. What is my discriminant here? 0. Now, can you say, when we are having discriminant is equal to 0, what type of roots we will get? If you see the rules, if discriminant is equal to 0, I will get real and equal roots. So, here if they ask to solve or comment on the nature of roots, what is the nature of the roots? If they ask, right now they have not asked according to book, they are just asking discriminant. So, nature of roots will be real and equal. Now, question number 12, they are asking prove that none of the following equation has any real solution. Does not have any real solution means, any real solution means they are having imaginary solution. So, first we found discriminant. Discriminant was equal to negative. Here, third point you see, when discriminant is less than 0, that means negative, then real, they are not real and unequal. Does not have any real solution. Obviously, it is not they, this quadratic equation does not have any real solution because of the root. So, once we will find out the nature of the roots, after that only we can say this equation does not have any real solution. We will write like this, any real solution. Understood? Now, in the same way, question number 11, 12, 13, 15, 16 you can solve. But here I will solve question number 14 for you. Now, question number 14 says, For what value of k will each of the following equations give equal roots? Also find the solution for the value of k. Now my dear students, I have not taught you till now to find out the solutions. So you please don't find the solution right now. You have to only solve up to part 1. That's for what value of k each of the solution will have equal roots. Only this much you have to solve. Then when I will teach you how to find out the solution, then at that time you all will be able to get the exact answers. Now, how to find the value of k? At least value of k we can find. Same is the case with question number 13. Find the solution is mentioned. No need to find the solution right now. I have not taught you. So only you have to comment on the nature of roots. So let's take question number 14. So nature of roots we have to find so that equal roots. Question number 14. Let's take b part. Okay, b only. Enough of a. Kx square minus of 4x plus of 1 is equal to 0. This is given. Now we have to find the value of k for which the roots are equal. When we are having roots equal, when discriminant is equal to 0. So first we will write here a is equal to k. A is equal to k. B is equal to minus 4. And c is equal to 1. Now when discriminant is equal to 0, then roots are real and equal. This much we know. So let's start with calculating d. D is equal to b square minus 4ac. So d is equal to b is how much? Minus 4 square minus 4 into a into c. No, sorry, not c. K, no? A is equal to K, A is equal to K. So this is equal to 16. 16 minus 4K. 16 minus 4K, D. Now when discriminant is 0, so we will write 16 minus 4K is equal to 0. 4K is equal to 16. K is equal to 4. So what is the value of K? K is equal to 4. This is method 1. Other way you can write, instead of writing this so many things, same thing you have to write but in a standard way. So you can write b square minus 4ac is equal to 0. Sorry, b square minus 4ac is equal to minus 4 square minus of 4k into 1. Here you will write 0 because discriminant is equal to 0, already have mentioned here. So it will be 16 minus 4k, 16 minus 4k. So 4k is equal to 16, k is equal to 16 by 4 is equal to 4. So only these many things, only three lines, no need to go one by one. Instead of putting, you can write b square minus 4ac is equal to, substitute the value. This side you write equal to 0, transfer this side and then simplify. In this way, you all will be able to solve, I hope, up to question number 16 from question number 11. I did not tell you from question number 1. I told you from 11 to 16, you have to practice at your home and then find out the nature of roots based on these three formulas, these three rules, not formulas, based on these three rules. Okay, I hope you all will do this. Thank you.